Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. Take a look at this. That is my new car. Today's big idea is an engineering challenge, and we're going to take a closer look at how to build this car and where it gets its energy from. We've zoomed in so you can see inside my car to see where it gets its energy from. Take a look. It's a rubber band. Watch what happens when I wind the car up. The rubber band gets stretched, and that is my form of energy. I wind it up, and now we'll zoom out and you can watch the wheel spin. So we've wound up our rubber band inside the car, and that energy is ready to do some work. It makes my car go fast. So we've cut our tube in half so you can get a better look at what's going on inside of our car in the rubber band. You can see I've joined two rubber bands together here, and we'll talk about how I did that in a second. All I do is I have a wooden skewer, and I've actually taped a bent paper clip to that skewer so I can hook on my rubber band. And now all I need to do is wind it up. Wind, wind, wind. My rubber band stretches, and now I have all that energy ready to do some work. Let it go, and you can see my axle spin even after the rubber band's off of it. Now you can find a lot of different designs online for rubber band powered cars, but we took a lot of time to think this through and make it kid friendly and classroom friendly. A lot of those designs require power tools and drills and hot glue guns and poking holes with hot items. Here, we really designed this to be kid friendly, classroom friendly. All you need are some really basic supplies to make this car work. So what are those basic supplies? Well, first, we're going to take a look at the wheels. To do that, I'm just going to pull this off. And you can see I have nothing more than a wooden skewer. And these little plastic wheels are the bottom to plastic cups. Take a look at this. So this is how we made our wheels. Now, a lot of times people might try to cut them out and draw a circle on cardboard, but it's difficult to get a really round wheel. We find, why draw something round when we can find something that's already round and just use it? Take a look at the bottom of this cup. All I need to do is take a pair of scissors, cut into the cup, down to the bottom, around, and I have a perfectly round wheel. So how do I make a hole without a power tool? To make our hole, all we need is a push pin. Now, the nice thing about most cups, there's markings on the bottom of the cup, which helps us try to figure out where the center of that cup is. So I'm just going to take my push pin, and to be safe, I'll put it on the table to get it started. I push it through, and now I have the beginning of a really small hole. How do I make it bigger? Well, that's where I use my wooden skewer. You can see the end of my skewer is tapered to a point. And what that allows me to do is push this through just by twisting and pushing. It makes my hole the perfect size, and believe it or not, the plastic makes it so that my wheel doesn't split. You can try using a paper cup or a styrofoam cup, but we've found that hole actually gets too big. So plastic is the way to go. So I cut out two wheels, put it on my wooden skewer axle, and it's time to see if this thing actually rolls. To do that, I give it a little push, and it works just great. So I have my two axles all made up. I have my front axle, my back axle, and this rubber band is going to stretch from the front of my tube, and I have to connect it to the back axle. How do I do that? Well, if you look in our car, I used a thumbtack. I could tape a paperclip and bend it, but it's really difficult to bend the paperclip just right, especially if you're a kid. A thumbtack actually works really well. So let's take a look at how to do that. So we pulled the wheels off the back axle, and I'm going to take my thumbtack, I'm going to take my skewer, put it down on the desk, and this is the hardest part. Being really careful, I'm going to push my thumbtack into my skewer. You might need to take something like a scissors and just tap it. And it's going to look like your skewer splits. We're going to zoom in so you can see what the wood does. We've zoomed in so you can see what the wood skewer does when I push the push pin through. You can see it starts to split, and that's okay. It actually makes it easier for the push pin to push through. But we will want to put some tape around the skewer to keep it from splitting all the way down. So here we go. So now all we're going to do is take some tape, any tape will work, and wrap it around my skewer on both sides to keep it from splitting all the way down the skewer. Wrap it around. And now I'm ready to put my wheels back on one side, another side, and now I have my front and back axle ready to go. So how do we get our axles into our tube at just the right spot? If I put it up too high, my wheels won't be on the ground. If I put it down too low, my thumbtack will actually hit the bottom of my tubes. So all I did with my axle made up is I held my axle just where I want it to go, where the thumbtack's gonna have just enough clearance. And then look at the side. I made a mark on one side and the other side where it hits. And I drew a line all the way down my tube so that I know that just the right spot to put my axle through. To make the hole in the tube, all I need is my thumbtack. I'll make a new one for you. Goes right into my cardboard tube. Work it around. Now, how do I make that little tiny hole bigger? That's where my skewer or a pencil comes in. Take that tapered point. I want to push and twist at the same time. And now I have a little hole for my axle to go right through. So let's put this through. I'll pull my thumbtack out. Take one wheel off. Through one. Through the other. Now all I have to do is put my thumbtack back in. Put my wheel back on. And now I have a spinning axle ready to go. So the last thing to look at is our energy source and how we attach it to the front of our car. So I used rubber bands that I put together to form a long string. So how do I do that? Well, really simple. I can overlap the two rubber bands and I'm just gonna pull that end and that end through and they're joined. I made that look really easy. You might struggle with that the first few times, but once you get it, it's a piece of cake. So now we've zoomed in to show you how we attach this. And to do that, I'm just gonna pull off this piece of tape so you can see what's going on here and how simple it is. All I have is a hole that I pulled the rubber band through, and to keep it from going through all the way, I took a little part of the skewer, and when I pull the rubber band, it stays in place and put a piece of tape. So how do we make that hole? Let's take a look at it. So this is metal, but it's a really thin metal, and let's see if I can push this push pin right through it. And I got it right through. I wiggle it. How do I make that hole bigger? The same exact way. Take my skewer. A little more force. And now I have a bigger hole. And if I need to make it even bigger, I can use a pencil that's wider than that. Maybe even the tip of a scissors. Push it in, spin it, and now I have a really big hole. So I have my bigger hole. Now I have to thread my rubber band through. I can push it through. And once I get this far enough in, I can reach in from the backside and pull it down the rest of the way. Then I just take a little bit of skewer that I cut off, tuck it under there, pull it tight, and I'm ready to tape it in place. So we have our rubber band car all assembled. How do we wind it up to make it work? Well, so I've used the skewer to reach in there and grab that rubber band, and as I turn my axle, the thumbtack's gonna catch it, and now I can wind it up. And you can experiment and play around with how much you wind it, how tightly you wind the rubber band. But you got to keep one thing in your mind. You have to figure out which way to wind it to make it go forward. Let's see if I wound it up the right direction. My car just went backwards. I have to wind it the other direction to get my car moving forward. The cool thing about these rubber band cars is you can use all kinds of different materials to make your car work. I went to the dollar store. Is it okay to say dollar store? I went to the dollar store and found this little plastic basket, and I noticed there were holes in the side of the basket, and I realized I didn't even have to make holes in the side. I could put wooden axles through. I attached my rubber band to the front. You can see my little push pin on my axle. Let's take a look and see how this works. It's even easier to wind up because I can reach into the top, hook my thumbtack, wind it up, see if it works. Another working car. The cool thing about these rubber band cars is you can use all kinds of different materials to make your car work. I went to the dollar store and found this little plastic basket, and I noticed there were holes in the side of the basket, and I realized I didn't even have to make holes in the side. I could put wooden axles through. I attached my rubber band to the front. You can see my little push pin on my axle. Let's take a look and see how this works. It's even easier to wind up because I can reach into the top, hook my thumbtack, wind it up. See if it works. Another working car. The really cool thing about these cars is that I can use everyday classroom materials to build all kinds of different varieties of cars. And then I can actually become a scientist and test them out and see which one goes the farthest, which one goes the fastest, which one carries the most weight. I could stack pennies or paper clips or marbles in here and count them up and see which car can actually carry the most weight the furthest down the hallway. Science is so cool when you experiment and try new things and look at things that work and look at things that don't work and then try and figure out how to make them better and faster. Just really cool. If you want to learn more about engineering, check out our links and our other videos on the channel. Thanks for watching.